Lopez, and we are here today to answer all of your sports questions and needs. Mm-hmm. How are you doing today?
It's a great day. It was a beautiful weekend. The fair's in town. You know, can't help but be a beautiful weekend.
All right, so you went to the Orange County
Fair?
Oh,
yeah. You know, I took my kids.
Ate some deep fried Twinkie bacon.
I took my kids. The first hour was great. And then after, it was all downhill.
Okay.
Because these kids, yeah, they're young. So it was, they were two and one's going to be four. Yeah.
Oh,
it was all downhill from there. But the point is, I took them.
Good.
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Creating those memories.
Right. Now to sports.
All right. Let's get into some NBA talk and some NBA action. There's been a lot of things going on around the league the past couple of weeks.
Yes, there has.
Let's start right in it.
The biggest.
Jump right into it. Dwight Howard.
Howard.
The biggest.
In case any of you missed it, I actually had a chance to sit down and interview Dwight Howard. You can check that out. YouTube, King of LA Sports, new Dwight Howard interview. But yeah, Dwight Howard has signed a 4-year, $88 million deal. Houston Rockets. What do you think about that?
I think, bravo to Dwight. Would I sign him? No. The antics that he's pulled the past couple of years with Orlando first and then now with the Lakers, no. I would not sign him to any type of deal. He does not show any loyalty. He does not show any true commitment to what he's doing. I think he's just really looking for a paycheck. That's just my personal opinion. If I'm not mistaken, year two, he has the right to opt out of this contract as well, right?
So, yeah, so
in about two more years, look for another circus.
Yes.
Exactly, starring Dwight Howard, and let's see who he'll go to next. I just know. I would not continue to jump through rings of fire for a man who does not stay with the team.
Yeah, this guy is something else. In my interview, he was nothing but hurt. All he was, he just kept saying, he's hurt. You know, he's, for a big guy, he sure has a lot of feelings.
Dwight is soft as cotton. I'm sorry, he is. I'm not a Laker fan, but when I heard he was coming to the Lakers, all I did was shake my head.
Not
I was
even
like,
deep down?
No.
Oh, okay. Just checking.
I was like, no. I was like, why? Why would you? I mean, is he big? Yes, he's big. But here's my thing. He's been in the league 25 years. All he has is the post game.
He's 27.
All he has is the post game. All he has is a dunk. He has not developed his game, you know. And so that shows a lack of commitment as far as I'm concerned. And then, as I said, he's soft. And if you factor in the neck injury, the back injuries, my neck and my back, you know, what can he bring?
I have a bad back.
Okay, I understand that, but you're not out there playing either.
That's
getting
true.
Paid $88 million dollars for it. So I was never, you know, big on that move. But
yeah, let me ask you this. Do you think he'll be good next year?
No, he'll probably give you the same thing that he gave you last year.
You know, that's where I'm going to disagree, because he's never truly had someone to sit down and teach him how to be a center. He's been off natural talent and ability because he's always been the man his whole life in every sport, every team. And I think the Rockets just hired Hakeem Olajuwon to work with all their centers.
Yes.
I think that move right there is perfect for a guy like him because he respects Hakeem. Hakeem has rings.
Mm-hmm.
And I think he's going to teach him maybe not too much because Dwight Howard, you know, he does do his one thing and he doesn't do it that great. Mm-hmm. But if he learns a variety of moves, I think he can be effective.
But my thing is, it's too late in his career to start learning those variety moves.
Oh, it's never too late.
Oh, no, sweetie.
Miss Brianna, it's never too
normally
late.
Normally, the average player develops his game within 2 to 3 years with being in the league. After that 2-3 years, if you don't develop that, you don't pick it up. As I said, he's been in the league 25 years. So
he just hasn't had the proper coaching.
He hasn't had the proper attitude.
True.
He's had the coaching.
Attitude reflects leadership.
Remember the Titans.
Yeah. Thank you. Movie shout out. Remember the Titans bars.
But still, his attitude sucks.
Yeah.
His attitude does suck. And I wish him well. You know, more power to him. Hopefully, he'll get it together. Well, do I see them getting a ring? Do I see them being a threat? No.
I see them being a threat. You know, Final Four in the Western Conference. I don't see them maybe getting a ring. You know, but I think Dwight Howard has a better year than, you know, he has one of those Orlando years.
I put the Rockets probably at maybe the sixth or seventh best team in the West.
Oh, so the same as they were this year.
So, yeah, that's no improvement. Hmm. No improvement.
I think they're a top four team just because of the talent they have. I seen Chandler Parsons.
Mm-hmm.
I was there at the Laker game when he sent it to overtime when the Lakers were trying to get in the playoffs. God, that guy's a game changer. There's certain guys where I watch the game, I'm like, okay, this guy can change the game at any time. Mm-hmm. There's only a few guys out there like that. LeBron, I've seen Kobe, mm-hmm. those, and honestly, Chandler Parsons, and the guy from the Portland Trail Blazers. Who's their center? What's his name? Oh my gosh.
Oh, the one that wants to get traded because Dwight came. Yes. Can't think of his name, but no, he did.
Actually. No, I'm talking from the Trail Blazers. I can't believe I don't know this.
Oh, the actual trade.
Huh? LaMarcus Aldridge. You know? Okay. That's why.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Sorry
about
that.
You confused me because I know there was somebody that wanted to be traded once they picked up.
Oh,
the
it was ASIC.
From the Rockets.
Yeah, okay. It was ASIC. He wants to get traded. The Rockets are denying that mm-hmm. trade. So apparently they're going to run two big guys like that unless they want to see what they can possibly get because he's not he's a talented big man. Mm-hmm. You know, he's a talented big man. But yeah, so that's enough with Dwight Howard.
Okay.
If you want to check out that interview again. I did one. It's on YouTube.
Now the other big man
exit
that got
interview.
His exit interview. I'm like, bye-bye. Deuces. Another big man that got picked up was Andrew Bynum. He signed a two-year, $24 million deal with the Cavs. I think this is a good look for Andrew. He sat out all of last year because of injury, but I think this is going to motivate him to, because it's a young squad.
Mm-hmm.
So and he has a lot of talent around him. So
tons
I think he's going to be motivated to play better, get healthy, play better, and try to make a playoff run. Do I think they will get deep into the playoffs? Probably not, but I think it's a good look for him.
Yeah, I mean, great look. I mean, it fits right in right there.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Let's see, who else do we have? Tyreke Evans signed to the Pelicans. Okay, first of all, I'm sorry. The Pelicans, dude, really?
They're changing.
Who is afraid of a Pelican? I'm like, what kind of name? The Pelicans. Okay, I'm sorry. Moving on. He signs to the Pelicans $44 million. For 4 years. Now, Tyreke, I think he will fit good into his offense. He's a slasher. You know who is the best when he enters the lane and finishes at the rim. He may fit in well if they implement a two-guard system, I think. He's strong, and, you know, they have Drew Holiday. So playing those two off each
Watch
other, I think
them.
It will be really good. Both are great ball players who can take the defender off the bounce, and it's a good contrast. You know, Holiday can shoot the lights out, and Evans actually converts over 37% of his threes.
Yeah.
So I think he's actually a good fit. He can do nothing but help the Pelicans on in that sense. So I think it's a good move.
Yeah, they've been making some moves this year. Mm-hmm. I think, they made that trade when they traded Noel for Drew Holiday, mm-hmm. and that was a good move. And they look like a very good, young, up-and-coming team.
Mm-hmm.
The name sucks. The name's crap.
Right.
But the players on the team are good. So, I'm not going to argue with that. I thought that they're making some good moves there. Mm-hmm. It's good to see, up-and-coming franchise. The Cavaliers, let's go back to them.
Okay.
They've been making a couple other splashes. I believe they also signed Earl Clark.
Mm.
Earl Clark. I thought he was going, the word was he might sign with the Clippers,
mm-hmm.
but he ended up signing with the Cavs. So that's a good one. And I believe they also signed Jarrett Jack.
Mm.
Jarrett Jack from the Golden State Warriors.
Yes.
Yeah, they signed him to a nice deal.
Okay.
So that's a great signing. That brings leadership to their club, and it gives them a scorer, like an innovative scorer
mm-hmm.
to the table. There's tons of moves going on right now, and this is great. The Dallas Mavericks, they signed Jose Calderon.
Mm-hmm. And Monte Ellis.
Mm-hmm. So I don't know what they're doing. And they brought back Devin Harris, mm-hmm. who used to be a guard for them. So they got three potential starting point guards. And I don't know what that's about, but supposedly, I guess they're going to try to run smaller.
Well,
a little fast-paced offense.
To speak on Ellis, who opted out of his $11 million contract with the Bucks to sign with the Mavs. I think he could be an asset and a value if he limits his perimeter shot and focuses on more being like a rim attacker, And I think he would also be a good sixth man. I don't know if he would be good in the starting lineup, but I think he would be a good role player for the Mavs. So we'll see what they do with him.
Oh, before we move on, I can't believe how I forgot this. Ms. Brion, we haven't had a show since this happened. Chris Paul has re-signed with the Clippers.
Chris Paul has re-signed with the Clippers.
CP3.
Yes.
And they look like they almost have the same exact team from last year.
Hello.
They just got a new coach.
Hello.
Yeah, they added a few shooters.
Who's making the playoffs? Who's going to the finals? Okay, yeah. Well, maybe a little.
Clippers will probably, same exact thing that happened last year.
You know what, shut up.
No, but they're looking, they got Doc Rivers.
They have Doc Rivers. They have CP3. They've kept Blake Griffin. They added J.J. Redick and Dudley.
Sharp now, shooters. Those guys are sharp shooters.
Sharp shooters. I was going to say that a lot of people gave them a lot of flack when they traded for those guys. But as you said, Redick is a sharp shooter. He can move without the ball. Dudley is 40% from the three-point line. So it helped them. They kept Jamal Crawford, DeAndre Jordan. He needs to work on his free throws. Oof. Blake Griffin needs to work on your free throws as well. And you also, Blake, you need to work on your mid-range shot. I love you, Blakey, but come on, constructive criticism. Get a little bit of heart. Use your body in the post. Knock them down. Work on your mid-shot game. You'll be excellent. Love you.
This is going to make you happy. See, the Clippers, they're Lob City. They got the offense on lockdown. Their biggest problem to me last year was their defense. Mm-hmm. What better coach to bring in to help out your defense than Doc Rivers?
Doc Rivers.
What a great pickup. He was worth it. Like, they spent the draft... Worth it, because they're going to be a good team. So that draft pick, after the 15 pick in the NBA draft, mm-hmm. it becomes irrelevant.
Right.
The players aren't, the talent level is that bad. So that,
good job, Clippers. Good job. They're bringing Alvin Gentry back, and he rejoins the Clippers for his third stint, as an assistant head coach. So, you know, he was good on defense, or big on defense as well. So hopefully... Clippers, don't let me down. Can we get past the second round of the playoffs? Please do it for Miss Keisha Breon. Thank you.
Yeah, don't lose to the Lakers.
Speaking of the Lakers, I have a question for you.
Bring it.
How will the Lakers fare with the Howard trade? Without Buss, can this franchise, how are they going to operate? You know, will they be able to rebuild immediately as a contender? Or will they have to rebuild? Are they going to push for Carmelo and LeBron after the 2014 season? What do you think the Lakers are going to do?
Who needs Dwight Howard when we have Chris Kamen?
Former Clipper.
Ooh, Chris Kamen.
Former Clipper.
Yeah. We don't need Dwight Howard at all.
Whatever.
All right. Anyways, let's be real. Honestly, I hate to say it. I think the Lakers are... I would never want to say a team is just going to throw away a season. The Laker owners just got to convince the fans that they're actually trying this year. Mm-hmm. Look, I mean, come on. They're not committing any money past this season. Mm-hmm. There's only Nash's contract and the guy they just signed's contract, Young. Mm-hmm. Nick Young, those contracts are going past this season. Kobe's isn't even past this season. Mm-hmm. So they're setting it up to make big moves.
Okay, well, is Kobe's not past this season because he's talking about retiring after this year?
Oh, no.
I thought he said he wanted to retire.
He won't. He said he's got three more years.
Three more years?
That's why, and that was the reason, one of the main reasons Dwight left, because Dwight's camp contacted the Lakers and asked them, hey, what's up with Kobe? Is he leaving? Is he going to stay? Is he going to retire? Because Dwight wanted to take over the team. Kobe said he's staying. Dwight left. Mm. So Kobe... I have a feeling he made $85 million. He's going to make $85 million this year. So next year, he's going to try to recruit some of those guys. So he'll take the veteran minimum.
I don't think so.
I think so.
I don't think so. Not Kobe and that ego. I don't think he'll take that veteran minimum.
You know
not
what?
At all.
He has the ego, exactly. So he's financially stable, but he has an ego. He wants to win that sixth ring. So what's bigger, his ego or his want for money?
His ego.
Exactly. So the ego, he'll try to get that ring. And hey,
we'll see. It'll be interesting.
That's one thing I like about the Lakers is even they go out, they try to make big moves. Mm-hmm. They try to make the blockbuster deals. They try to do whatever they have to do for the team to win. And they've been the only team until recently that have taken advantage of being in LA for players to come. Mm-hmm. Look what we have. Come here. The Clippers are now starting to use that formula, mm-hmm. and they're gonna get a lot of free agents because really they're both LA teams. Mm-hmm. So. Yeah, so that the Clippers look like they're going to be good. But I want a couple, just another side note, Josh Smith to the Pistons.
Yes.
They took him away and they gave him big money.
Four years, $56 million.
$56 million. But I'm going to move on. This is my favorite of the favorite offseason signing, Andre Iguodala to the Golden State Warriors.
Yes.
That to me is the most impactful sign, more than Dwight Howard to the Rockets. This team is an up and coming team. Mm-hmm. Iguodala, in my opinion, is one of the most explosive players in the league.
Yes.
He has his times, you know, he's had some injuries, but he's still young, still explosive. He has the potential to put up 40 points a game.
And he can play defense.
And he's great at defense. He has that long length. Mm-hmm. That right there is the best pickup of the offseason for me, NBA wise, by far.
I can agree with that. That was an awesome pickup for them.
Yeah, and J.R. Smith re-signed with New York Knicks. What do you think about that?
Okay.
Well, yeah, so, you know, it's not a big deal, but he was a a lot of people were looking at him because he was the sixth man of the year, and
he
played great basketball coming off the bench, and they looked at him as potentially being another big star on the team like Harden was from a year before. So they ended up keeping him, which was a great signing.
I think that's a good move.
Yeah, and also along with the Knicks, Meta World Peace signed with the New York Knicks.
Yeah, Meta, he confuses me. He's, you know, I don't even know. I'm just going to leave it at that. Have fun in New York, Meta. He's just, I thought he wanted to go to China or coach Arena League football. He wanted to do something ridiculous.
If you know, well, I know him personally, but follow him on Twitter, and he can't take anything he says seriously. And he even makes jokes about it. He's like, I think it's funny that everyone believes everything I say.
Yeah, he's a weird one, but you know.
Yeah, and the Spurs, they're trying to come back from their, you know, they're upset. They should have been the NBA champions.
They should have.
They handed the Heat Game 6 on the silver platter, and the Heat chopped it up, and they ate it all.
Yes.
They ate everything on the platter.
Mm-hmm.
So, but they're trying to, you know, revamp their team. They re-signed Thiago Splitter, Manu Ginobili re-signed, and the move that I like is they got another sharp shooter, Marco Bellinelli, from the Chicago Bulls. They signed him to a two-year deal, and he's perfect. He looks like he fits right into that system. Great shooter. So,
going to make another run. So
yeah, and the last one, Carl Landry, you know, formerly of the Golden State Warriors, signed with the Kings. Kings threw big money at him for go a few hours away to play at Sacramento Kings.
So, good move for him.
Yeah.
He has to go far away from home. So,
yeah, and,
perfect.
Yeah, why don't you... And then the Clippers, one more move. They got rid of Bledsoe. You want to say your big goodbyes?
Yeah, but you know what, Bledsoe, you did us well. I'm not going to say unfortunately because we kept CP3, but we're no longer needed in Clipper Nation. So wherever you go, I wish you the best, and thank you for the years that you have put forth with the Clippers. Ciao.
What about Caron Butler? You want to say bye to him?
Bye.
Okay, I think that's all we have for NBA today, right?
That is all that we have for you today. King, tell them where they can reach you at.
Well, I'm the most reachable guy around. You can reach me, the King of LA Sports, on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. And on Twitter, you can reach me, Rich Lopez, KOLASE.
You can reach me on YouTube at Keisha Brion. And that is all that we have for you today. Until next time, may the sports be with you.
And don't be afraid to roll the dice. Have a good day.